Alright people, we are in a lobby of Abyss, and to begin with, you can use the gap in the server farms, you can use the bottom edge of the TV, and you can aim right under this edge of these lockers. And looking at an enemy over here, you can aim right under this edge of the railing. Now going further in, you can use this sign which goes right to the face. Going further in, you can aim right below this line of this vintage panel. You have a structure behind and you can aim right below the bottom edge of it. You can aim right below this yellow line and the top edge of this elevation. Now going into the A side, do you see the ledge behind? You can aim right below it. You can aim right above this structure. This is same as before. And the top edge of this box. And over here, it's pretty simple. Aim right below this box's edge and you should be good to go. Alright, this is going to be a little tricky, so I'm going to make it as clear as possible. So do you see the faint paint over here? Aim right below it and you can get a clear headshot. Or else you can always aim right below the shadow of this ledge or simply aim right above this structure. We have another visual cue here. You can aim right on the top edge of this panel. While looking at the tower, for an enemy who's close peeking, you can aim right above this box. For an enemy who's wide peeking from this area, you can aim right under this line. And just in case this door is broken, you can use the bottom tip of the circle. And for an enemy who's coming out of the vent, you can aim right above the floor. Okay, now we're gonna look into attacking the B side, and for a close peek from this area, you can use this line. This line can be used for a wide peek as well. And over here, you can simply aim right under this elevation. And moving further along into the B main, you can use the top border of the bottom box. Okay, this is gonna be a little tricky. For a close peek behind the pillar, aim right around this area, follow it, and boom, you have a headshot. And for a wide peek from behind the pillar, aim around this area, follow it, and you have a headshot. For a close peek from behind this box, aim right in the middle of the gap in the wall. And for a super wide peek from around here, do you see these circles? Aim around them. For a close peek from behind the pillar, aim around the vegetation right up over here. And for somebody peeking from behind the box over here, you can aim right below this vegetation or this gray line right up over here. Inside the site, you have a couple of options. You can use the top edge of the box. You can use the bottom edge of the gap in the wall. You can use this plank on the shelf. Entering through this area, you can aim right below the green patch. You can use the bottom edge of this fuse box. And up over here, you can aim right below this demarcation. For an enemy close peeking from B tower, you can aim right above this color demarcation. And for an enemy wide peeking, it's right below. For anybody close peeking you from here, aim at this part of the wall art. And for a super wide peek, aim at this part. So your play area over here is basically around this one and this part. When you're on B nest and you're expecting enemy from tower, aim right below this color demarcation. And it's the same for the enemy here as well. For an enemy peeking from behind the box, aim right below this green paint, below this gap in the wall. Aim nicely below this gap in the wall. And for a close peek, aim along this plank. For an enemy peeking from here, aim right above the bins. And for an enemy peeking from here, aim along this line. Now attacking mid, over here we have a couple of options. You can use the last tier. You can aim right below this tip of this wall art. And for a close peek over here, aim right below this box's top edge. Over here it's pretty clear, use the topmost line up over here and follow it. Over here it's needless to say it's above this line. It's this edge of the box, this plank, and above the stairs. And for anybody coming out of this area, you can aim right below this plank or use the topmost stair. And for anybody peeking from this area, you can aim right below the circle. And over here, it's right below this plank. For anybody peeking from mid top, you can aim right below this border. And for up over here, you can aim right on this border. And for a close peek from over here, aim right above the border. And for anybody coming in from here, just place your crosshair along this line. For people on the catwalk, use this line. And you can aim right below this border. For an enemy close peeking you from here, aim nicely above the floor. And for a white peek, aim right between these two planks. For a close peek from B side, aim on the circle. And for a white peek, aim above it. And for anybody coming from behind the pillar, aim along this line. This crosshair placement remains the same. And aim slightly below for a close peek. And right in the middle of this wall for a close peek from the right. While going into the B side, aim right above this line. Over here, you can aim right below the first hexagons. Over here, you can use the tip of the triangle or simply place it along this border. While entering the A side, you can aim right above this line. You can use the yellow wall's edge and also the box's edge. Okay, to begin with, we are back in A lobby and you can use this last tile up over here or aim above this dark patch. You can also aim right above this yellow line to get a clean headshot. Okay, this one is going to be a little tricky. Do you see these darkly colored hexagons? You can aim right below it to get a clean headshot. For an enemy standing over here, do you see this water damage on the wall? You can aim right below it to get a clean headshot. There are not many visual cues over here, but the only visual cue you can use is count 1, 2, 3, 4 hexagons and aim at the lower border of it. Over here, you can aim right below this yellow light or you can aim right below this shadow of the ledge. And over here, you can aim right below this line to get a quick headshot. So your play area over here is between the lower third of this rectangle, which lies straight up over here, and below this wall. So if an enemy is white peeking, you can aim right up over here to get a clear headshot. Or if an enemy is close peeking, you can aim right below this wall to get a clean headshot. So your play area for this angle is between this yellow line and this notch up over here. So if an enemy is close peeking, you can aim right up over here to get a clean headshot. Or if an enemy is wide peeking, you can aim it right up over here. Anywhere between this and this. Over here, it's the faint line again. You can aim right below it to get a clean headshot. Aim right above this line for a close peek. And nicely above this line for a wide peek. For a close peek over here, follow the tip of this yellow wall. Okay, the wide peek is going to be a little tricky. You see this triangle in the air and this line at the 3. Aim right along this to get a clean headshot over here. And for somebody who's just got off the rope, aim along the top third of this A3. And if you're expecting company from over here, aim nicely above this yellow line along the height of this poster. You can aim right above this switchboard to get a clean headshot over here. And also use this area of the switchboard to get a clean headshot over here. If you're expecting company from over here, aim right below this wall art. This one remains the same. For a close peek over here, count 2 tiles down and aim right over here. And for a wide peek, aim right above the first tile. Basically, your play area over here is from here to here. For a close peek over here, aim nicely above this gold line. And for a wide peek, aim right on this line. For anybody peeking from over here, follow this plank to this tip of the arch. And for enemies peeking you from here, aim right above this plank. For enemies super close peeking you from here, aim right below this tile. and for the enemy is wide peeking you from here, aim right above it. For close peeking enemies from behind the pillar, aim right above this line. And for the enemy is wide peeking you from here, use this line on the ledge. For close peeking enemies from the bend, use this line again. And for wide peeking enemies, aim a little higher. For close peeking enemies from the bend, aim right below this plank. And for enemies peeking from behind the pillar, you can aim along this line. And for super wide peeking enemies, you can aim below this one. For enemies peeking you from behind the shelf, aim along this plank. So the entire play area over here is between this plank and this plank. For enemies peeking you at the catwalk, use the bottom line of this triangle. Aim along this plank if you're expecting company from over here, and below this plank if you're expecting company from over here. Aim nicely above these logs of wood if you want to get a clean headshot. Or you can simply use this tip of the triangle. If you're holding this angle, you can use the tip of the triangle. These are your visual cues for this area, that is right above the handles, the top edge of the pad, and the top edge of the screen. And this remains the same even if you're on the tower. And for a close peek, aim right below the desk. So your play area over here is between the screen's top edge and the desk. If anybody is peeking you from here, aim right above this tip to get a clean headshot. If somebody is close peeking you from here, aim nicely below this line or along this line. And for a wide peek, aim slightly below the same. If someone is wide peeking you from here, aim nicely above this ledge. And if somebody is close peeking, aim right above the stairs. If you're standing on the nest, aim along this curve. And for a close peek, aim right in the middle of this tile. If somebody is close peeking you from here, aim right above this tile. Your play area for this angle is between this slope and this line. So for a wide peek, aim around here. And for a close peek, aim around here. For a wide peek from over here, aim right below this line. And for a close peek over here, aim right below this line. For a wide peek over here, aim along this line. And aim slightly above this border for a close peek. If somebody decides to wide peek you from over here, count 1, 2, 3, 4 and hold it along this log. And for a close peek, count 1, 2, 3 and hold it along this log. For a close peek over here, aim nicely below this line. And for a wide peek, aim nicely above. If someone is wide peeking you from here, aim around this water damaged part of the wall. And for a close peek, aim right above this panel. For a wide peek from over here, aim right below this line. And for a close peek, aim slightly below. For anybody in the nest, you can use this circle. Do you see these white patches over here? You can stick around the top edge of these white patches for the entire nest area. Aim right above this curve to get a clean headshot. For a wide peek coming in from here, aim nicely above this line along this curve. And for a close peek, aim around this line. There's a fuse box here as well, so you can use the bottom edge of it. Or simply count 1, 2, 3, 4 and get a clean headshot. For this area, aim right below this rectangle and you're good to go. You can use the bottom tip of this pillar to get a clean headshot too. If somebody is close peeking you from the link, aim right below this line. And for a wide peek, aim slightly lower.